Drugs are everywhere, more than ever. Drugs can be anything. Anybody can have a problem with substance use. In 97, when the member states decided to create the early warning system, nobody would have guessed that 10 years later, we would have two new psychoactive substances discovered on the European market every week. IPA is the instrument for pre-accession. We are talking about a group of countries that are the southeastern European countries belonging to the Western Balkans and also Turkey that have applied for having a status of candidate country to the EU. There is the EU acquis on drugs that is part of the package of legislation and practice that they need to adopt in order to be ready one day to maybe join the EU.
The mutual interests consist of, first of all, we supporting them to align their systems to the European standards, but also us to understand better what is happening in the region and how this impacts on the European Union. The main threats are twofold. They are linked to security and to health. So we're looking now at cross-border security and health threats in the region and how this can impact on the European Union.
For the EU, these countries are also very important. They're on a very important trafficking routes into the European Union. There's also historically countries that organised crime groups have been very active in targeting the EU in terms of drug supply. One of the things that are very important for the new countries that are looking to join the European Union is that they have the same evidence base and able to develop the same policy responses to drug problems and benefit from the European model, reducing the harms that drugs cause, working with the individuals on the health side, but also with strong drug control policies.
We started our cooperation with the region in 2008. And now already with the seventh project. During the previous projects, we were really only looking at establishing the EU acquis in those partners in the field of drugs and drug information. So that means also institutional building, establishing a national drug observatory, a national early warning system on new psychoactive substances. Now, under this project, we have an additional objective, and not the least one, which is really to shed light and to bring evidence on these cross-border security and health threats, and to show also through evidence how this impacts the European Union on a day-to-day. There is also, of course, a very important interest for us to show evidence that there should be more access to treatment, there should be more investment on prevention and on other harm reduction activities in those countries. When we see the countries and our partners evolving in the right way, for instance, establishing a national strategy on drugs in line with the EU strategy, which has been quite an achievement for many years, we feel, I think, as a colleague, very positive, and we have been contributing positively to this evolution in time. Yeah.